teaching reading skills, reading as a language skill, reading strategies to help in learning. While we may underestimate reading and view it as a fairly easy skill to teach when compared to listening, speaking, and writing, it still entails a complex cognitive process. Reading requires interaction between a reader and a text, and for the reader to be able to decode letters, words, and sentences. Reading always has a specific purpose. We might read to gain information, like when we read newspapers, or we might read for pleasure, like when we read novels, fiction, or poetry. And finally, we also read to learn. Most of our reading in school is reading to learn. The reason for reading determines our approach to reading comprehension. For instance, when we read a menu, we might want to skim through the prices without paying a lot of attention to the names of the dishes. When reading an essay, we tend to dig deeper so we can identify the main idea and its supporting arguments. When reading for language acquisition, we're trying to learn things like vocabulary, grammar, and sentence structure in the context of authentic texts. When they are reading to learn, we want our students to follow these five basic steps. Identify why the students are reading to make it a meaningful learning experience. Identify which parts of the text match with the goal. Activate background knowledge related to the reading task. Choose relevant reading strategies and use them where they fit best. Check the student's understanding both while reading and after the reading task has been completed. There are a number of reading strategies that we need to teach our students to make them better readers. These include skimming, scanning, intensive reading, extensive reading, inferring, and predicting. Let's take a look at the key characteristics of each strategy and how to use them successfully in the classroom. Skimming allows students to quickly understand the gist of a text. Skimming comes in handy when the text is long or there's a lot of material and a limited amount of time, such as only 45 minutes for the lesson. When skimming, students should be asked to read the title, underline and translate any unknown words, and write those words on the board. Read the first sentence of every paragraph. Examine the pictures. Translate any unknown expressions or phrases. Scanning helps students find specific information quickly in the text. If there are questions about the text at the beginning of the activity, then students can scan for key words or phrases that might answer those questions. Tips for scanning. Ask questions before the text has been read so students can look for key words or phrases. Have students work in pairs to find the right information. Translate unknown words or phrases and write those words on the board. Use aids like headings, topic sentences, and subheadings. Extensive reading is when students read longer texts for general understanding and enjoyment. So a teacher might read a short story with the students, but not give any other tasks besides reading and listening. The main objective of extensive reading is to get students to like reading in English and to enhance their reading fluency. Intensive reading is when students read for specific information. Intensive reading activities include skimming a text for specific information in order to complete tasks which come after the reading activity, like fill-in-the-gap exercises or answering true-false questions. Scanning a text to complete tasks which come after the reading activity, like matching headings to paragraphs or scanning jumbled passages and then reading them carefully to put them in the correct order. One additional reading strategy is inferring. Inferring means figuring out something that the author does not explicitly state in a text. Students use clues within the text to think of what the author might be trying to imply. This strategy is effective for improving your students' ability to draw conclusions and make inferences. Another reading strategy is predicting. Predicting is when students guess what the text is about from the first paragraph, the title, or picture clues. We can make use of this particular reading strategy. Before reading, when students are asked to think about the title, illustrations, and pictures, and guess what the text might be about. During reading, when students are asked to stop in the middle of the reading exercise and predict what will happen next. After reading, when students check their predictions. Deducing meaning from context is one more reading strategy where students guess the meaning of an unknown word from the context. Finally, it is very important for us to teach our students the sequence of events, that is, to identify what comes first, second, third, and so on in the story. So, after reading a story, learners should indicate what the key events in the story are and in what order they happened. Varying the reading strategies, along with the interaction patterns, can greatly increase the effectiveness of your reading lesson or activity.